Hi, I'm Arne from the Chrome Web Store team. I'm here to talk about some of the reasons we started working on the concept of web apps for Chrome and the ways that you as a developer can get started writing these apps. The idea for a web store grew out of an observation that the way the web works has changed significantly in the past few years. New standards such as HTML5 give developers more flexibility in the types of experiences the web can provide. The pace of browser development has also sped up, so these new features are shipped to end users a lot faster than they were in the past. Developers have used these new features to write increasingly sophisticated sites, so the idea of a website as a place to consume text-based content has become out of date. Developers are writing websites to act as real-time email clients, listen to streaming music, and play multiplayer games, functionality that's traditionally associated with desktop apps. Many of Google's own services push the limits of what can be done on a web page. Tools like Gmail, Docs, and Maps are quintessential web apps that use the browser as an application platform instead of a content renderer. We believe that the web has reached a point where these kinds of apps are only going to become more ubiquitous. We wanted to make the experience of launching an app quick and direct, just like a desktop application. So we've retooled the Chrome's new tab page to display a list of your most commonly used apps as a series of big, beautiful icons so that getting to the apps you love is as quick as possible. A lot of the new HTML5 features like geolocation and notifications help make apps very powerful, but at the same time require explicit permission from the user. A complex app may need lots of these features, which leads to a bad experience if the user has to click on a bunch of approval boxes before being able to use the app. To address this, we made apps require an explicit install flow. When a user decides to install an app, they'll be presented with the permissions that the app requires in an easy-to-understand list. When they approve the permissions, then the app will be installed to and launched from the new tab page. Finally, while we think Google Search is the best way to find sites on the web, we understand that users use many more metrics when selecting apps to use. So we built the Chrome Web Store as a dynamic gallery. Users filter apps by category, read reviews and ratings, and even get personalized recommendations of apps to try. The Chrome Web Store is integrated with the Chrome browser, so it is easy to access directly from the new tab page. It also offers an integration with Google Checkout, so if an app requires payment to use, the buying process is straightforward, without the user needing to input a credit card for each purchase. One important point to note is that while we added additional UI and functionality to support apps in Chrome, we didn't add any additional proprietary APIs or technologies to learn. Web apps in the Chrome Web Store are built using the same standards-based tools that you would use to create any other website. In fact, any website can be deployed as an app simply by filling out a simple manifest file and uploading it to the Web Store. Apps that require payment can take advantage of open technologies, such as OpenID and OAuth, to interact with our license server, or they can use any other existing payment or user infrastructure if they wish. The key difference, then, is more about how a web app should be designed than how it is built. We expect web apps to deliver a tight focus and a rich user experience. In this sense, a web app in the store should be more like a mobile application designed for a larger screen, rather than a packaged install of a website. And because apps can use all of the features supported by Google Chrome, they can be fast, dynamic, and powerful without having to worry about legacy compatibility. Hopefully this video has gotten you excited to try creating a web app of your own and posting it to the store. There's an easy learning curve to get started, and if you already use a developer channel version of Chrome and have a text editor, you have all the software you need to get started. Just visit code.google.com/chrome/apps to read tutorials and documentation on building apps. Happy coding!